Hello and welcome to today's author webinar. Thank you for joining us. I'm Navanithan and I'm part of the learning and content management team. I'm now going to log into the author main menu. Yeah, here it is. This is the author main menu. Prior to submitting your revision, it is important to understand the journal specific requirements, as this may vary from journal to journal. The first area where you can find the instruction is under the about section. You will be able to locate the instruction for authors. This is the guide for authors. You can just click this link to know the specific instructions for submitting your revision. The second place where revision instructions can be found is the decision letter which you have received via email. This letter may also easily be accessed via Editorial Manager from your author main menu. Click the submissions needing revisions folder, which was found under the revision section. Now you will be able to see the submissions which are ready for revision. Under the view decisions column, you will be able to see the decision term which is linked here. You can just click this decision term to view the decision letter. I'm just going to click this. This action will open the editor decision letter. If you click the link, this letter will contain journal specific instructions for preparing your revision, as well as any editor and reviewer comments. Everything will be included here. In the top of the letter, you will be able to see a link where, if you can click the link, the documents related to the revisions can also be downloaded. Now I'll get back to the site. You can see the action menu here, and you will be able to see various links under action menu. To just see the files which you uploaded in the original version, you can just click the file inventory link. You can just decide on the files which you have uploaded during the original version. Next, to prepare your revised manuscript file and any other files as described in the decision letter, if the research is being supported by funding, be sure you have the details available, including the funding body and grant numbers. If you have co-authors, verify that you have the current affiliation and contact details of all authors. If there are any changes to the author list, such as adding or removing an author or changing the author order, you must have the agreement of all authors. By clicking the file inventory, you will be able to view the files which you uploaded in the original version. Also, you will have the option to download all the files as a zip folder. And if you would like to proceed with the revision process, you can just click the revise submission link under the action column. You will now be able to see a warning. If you want to proceed later, you can just click cancel. If you have all the files ready and you want to proceed with the revision process, then you can just click the OK button. In the first step, you will be prompted to confirm the article type. Please note that changing the article type during revision is very rare. Doing so may result in different required files or different required information. Please refer to the guide for authors for more information on this. Whenever you are ready, please click with the proceed button. The next step is the attach file step. In the attach file step, you will be able to see the files which was uploaded during the original version. You can just retain the files which you had in the original version. Say, for instance, I'm going to update the manuscript. I have updated the manuscript file. Then you just need to check out the tick box here so that this file will not be included in the revision. And I want to include the cover letter, declaration of interest, as I have not made any changes. I'm going to include this in the revision process. Once ready, you can just click proceed. And as I said before, I'm now just going to upload the manuscript file to which I have made it any changes. once uploaded, make sure the to check if the item type is selected here. If you see here in the top, you will be able to see the required for submissions section, where if you have missed any files, this will be highlighted here. So you can just check and upload those files. For here, we can see that the detailed response to reviewers is missing. So I am going to select this item type. And I'm going to click the browse button. I'm going to upload this. Please make sure you don't upload any duplicate files so that you will receive any error message. Also, you can upload multiple files by using the drag and drop option. The order of the files is automatically taken care of by the system. However, in some instances, if you're going to upload multiple figures and you would like to change the order of the figure as per your requirement, you will be able to see the change order section, where you can just change the order as per your wish. If you just change the order numbering here and click the update file order, the order will be listed as per your requirement. To remove any files during the revision process, you can just select the files and click the select checkbox here, and you will be able to see the remove button. You can just remove the files if you want to remove any files in the revision process. Once the files are finalized for the revision process, you can just click proceed. Please make sure there is not any two versions of the files uploaded when you are uploading the files in the attach files step. The next step is the general information step. In the general information step, you will be able to see the classifications which you selected for the journal previously. If you want to make any modifications, you can do this here and then click proceed. Okay, this is the reviewer preference step. For some journal, the reviewer preferences is a mandatory step where the authors would have been asked to select the reviewers, preferred reviewers for their manuscript. If you want to make any changes here, you can just make the changes. If you want to add another suggested reviewer, you can just add these details here. In some instances, you may ask for a new information of this revision. For example, the journal may require more information at the revision stage or have added a new requirement since your original submissions. In those scenarios, you should need to provide the information. Also, you have the option to update the opposed reviewers section here. Once done, you can just click proceed. You will be asked to review your additional information section here. You can just review the responses which you provided for the original version. And for some journals, during the revision part, you may be having some additional questions here. So you need to check, review the questions and provide your response. The response which I have provided here is already intact. So there is not any changes here. So I'm now going to proceed with the revision process. The next step is the comments section. If you can see the comments which you have provided in the original version of the manuscript here. If you have not provided, it will be blank. Even during the revisions, revision part, you can provide any specific comments here for the revisions. And the next is respond to reviewers. Some journals would ask authors to provide response to the reviewers. So if you want to respond to the reviewers in this text box, you can also click the view decision letter, where the decision letter will be opened and you can just check the reviewer comments and provide your responses here. So based on the queries raised by the reviewers, you can provide your responses here. Once you have provided the response, you can just click with proceed. In the additional manuscript data, make sure to review all the details which you have provided in the original submission. This is final because once if your manuscript is accepted for publication, the metadata presented here will be used. So it is better to check each and every field in the manuscript data part. So I'm just going to check the title here, abstract. And here you have the option, as I mentioned earlier, you have the option to edit the author details. If there is any change in the affiliation or any other details, you can just click the pencil icon here. So you will have the option to update the institute details, or if you feel you want to update the contributor roles, you can update here. Also, you have the option to add any new co-author or remove any co-author, but please make sure the addition and deletion of the co-authors are done with the agreement of all authors. So it is a mandatory step to receive confirmation from all authors if you wish to add or delete an author, or if you are going to change the order of authors. So the next part is funding information. If there is any missing information required in the steps, you will be able to see a red asterisk symbol here. So it's a warning that you should review and provide the proper details. Indicate that if there is any grant support for one author, make sure that you provide the grant information here by just clicking the Add Funding Source button. If you don't have any funding source for your manuscript, you can just simply select Funding Information is not available. So we have completed with the revision process now. You can either save and submit later. If you wish, you just want to save this work and submit the revision to the journal on the later stage, you can just click Save and Submit later. Once this is done, the saved submission will now be reaching your incomplete revisions for authors folder. You will be able to see the manuscript listing under the incomplete revisions for author folder. From here, you can initiate the revision process by just clicking Edit Revision button. As you can see, you can just click Proceed for each step. You'll be able to see different milestones indicated in a green tick. If you have already provided the details correctly in each and every step, you can directly go to the final step, which is the manuscript data milestone, and just click here. If you feel all the information providers appropriate and you can proceed further with the revision process, then you can click the Build PDF for Approval button. The building PDF process might take a couple of minutes. Once the Build PDF process is initiated, the submission will then move to the revisions revision waiting for author approval folder. Here you will be able to see the view revision button and other buttons in the action menu once when the PDF is built. So once before you want to confirm the PDF is built properly, you can just click the view revision button and it will help you to open and download the PDF. So you can review the revision PDF, and if everything is fine, you can proceed further. If there are any changes required, or if you feel there needs to be some modifications done, then you can proceed by clicking Edit Revision and you can make the changes. Once you feel that after reviewing the PDF, everything is fine and you want to move with the revision process further, you just need to click the Approve Revision link and please click the OK button. The revision is now submitted to the journal and the revision will now appear under revisions being processed folder. Here you will be able to see the revisions being processed folder. Once when you submit the revisions, you will be able to access the revision file from here. That brings us to the end of our webinar today. Thank you for joining us. See you next time. Thank you.